We knew from the day I got arrested that I was innocent. We just didn't know how long it was going to take for us to prove it.
A prisoner hopes the Missouri Supreme Court will answer an important legal question in the state. Is innocence enough to free a person? Believe it or not, that's an unanswered question in Missouri. Here's KCTV 5 investigative reporter Angie Rocono.
Chris Dunn has spent 30 years in prison for a murder he swears he didn't do. Here's what will shock you. If he was on death row, he'd be free. A judge actually wrote that. But Dunn was sentenced to life plus 90 years. So he's waiting for the Missouri Supreme Court to answer the question, is innocence enough?
I want my freedom. I need my freedom.
It is good to meet you.
Me too.
Thank you for trusting me to do this.
It's rare to meet someone who would be better off if they were sentenced to death.
They would have let me go a long time ago.
That's the case for Chris Dunn.
I hate waking up in prison every day. I'd rather go to sleep and not wake up until they come out with a ruling.
He's convicted in a 1990 St. Louis murder that took place in the dark.
We heard the gunshots. Next thing you know, we seen all police cars driving down the street.
A teenager named Rico Rogers was shot and killed on a porch. No physical evidence ever connected Chris Dunn to the crime.
Did you know the person who was shot?
No.
You know, that person's a stranger?
A stranger.
But several teenagers said it was Chris Dunn. They now admit they lied.
They was young at the time, too.
So was Dunn.
I'm 18 years old. I'm facing a murder charge. And I don't know nothing about the law, except the police is there, there's jail right there, and where handcuffs are.
He was arrested and later convicted. He spent his entire adulthood in various prisons.
If you think that I'm guilty of a crime, then give me a new trial. Give me a fresh shot. I deserve that.
The case against Chris Dunn has fallen apart. It wasn't much to begin with. The case hinged on eyewitness testimony of a 12 and 14-year-old running in the dark. Both have recanted and admitted to perjury. Here's the affidavit of the 12-year-old who's now an adult. We decided that we would both testify it was Christopher Dunn who killed Rico. The truth is, we did not know who shot at us and killed Rico. The then 14-year-old admits in his affidavit, I lied on Chris Dunn to save myself. Dunn's legal team points out both juveniles received sweet deals for their crimes after their testimony and the Rico Rogers murder. The case takes its biggest turn with the best friend of Rico Rogers. He was there that night, but no one tracked him down. Here's his sworn affidavit. I was standing right next to Rico when he was shot. I was positive that none of us could see or identify the shooter. He points out if someone questioned him, I would have testified that Chris Dunn's name came up after the shooting as speculation. And from there, people began to believe the shooter had been Chris Dunn, even though none of us could see the shooter. There's more. Two women say they talked with Chris Dunn the very night around the time of the shooting. One was in the hospital giving birth, so she's sure of the date. And she remembered the time because of the show she was watching. The other says her mother refused to let her testify back in the 90s because she didn't want her involved in a murder trial. And then Chris's family was with him. They all heard shots together and went back inside.
So when you heard the gunshots, first thing my mother said was, "These fools shooting, let's go."
All of this information has been known for years and presented in the courts, both in affidavits and in sworn testimony at a recent hearing. Dunn thought his nightmare was over.
When the first witness signed his affidavit and they sent it to me, I felt a little hope. When the second witness was found 15 years later, I felt a little hope. But eventually that hope started diminishing.
Things are murky in Missouri when cases fall apart. The law is clear, you can't kill that person. But a judge questioned if he could set Christopher Dunn free. A freestanding claim of actual innocence is only cognizable for a petitioner who has been sentenced to death and is unavailable for cases in which the death penalty has not been imposed.
It won't never end.
Which is why we recently interviewed Dunn in prison.
I'm still in prison. It don't make no sense. It was enough evidence. It was good enough evidence for you to convict me, but still it's not good enough evidence for you to free me now.
His legal team is asking the Missouri Supreme Court to clarify Missouri law and rule, is being innocent enough?
We will keep you posted on what the Missouri Supreme Court decides and if they will review the case. That could happen as early as tomorrow. Angie Ricono, KCTV 5 News.
Chris Dunn is supported by Miracles of Innocence. That's the new Innocence Project started by Lamont McIntyre and Reverend Daryl Burton. They've both been the focus of KCTV 5 investigations. They were also wrongfully convicted and now fight to free other innocent prisoners.